Chapter 2 Promise Chapter 1 Page 13 It was to redeem us that Jesus lived and suffered and died. He became a man of sorrows that we might be made partakers of everlasting joy. God permitted his beloved Son, full of grace and truth, to come from a world of indescribable glory to a world marred and blighted with sin, darkened with the shadow of death and the curse. He permitted him to leave the bosom of his love, the adoration of the angels, to suffer shame, insult, humiliation, hatred, and death. The chastisement of our peace was upon him, and with his stripes we are healed. Isaiah 53, verse 5. Behold him in the wilderness, in Gethsemane, upon the cross. The spotless Son of God took upon himself the burden of sin. He who had been one with God felt in his soul the awful separation that sin makes between God and men. This wrung from his lips the anguished cry, my God, why hast thou forsaken me? Matthew 27, verse 46. It was the burden of sin, the sense of its terrible enormity, of its separation of the soul from God. It was this that broke the heart of the Son of God. But this great sacrifice was not made in order to create in the Father's heart a love for man, not to make him willing to save. No, no. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. John 3:16. The Father loves us not because of the great propitiation, but he provided the propitiation because he loved us. Christ was the medium through which he could pour out his infinite love upon a fallen world. God was in Christ, reconciling the world unto himself. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 19. God suffered with his Son. In the agony of Gethsemane, the death of Calvary, the heart of infinite love paid the price of our redemption. Step to Christ, page 13, June 28.